Good morning, everybody. It's Saturday. How are you doing? I hope that you are awake and ready to do some stretching. And I hope that you saw the post earlier this morning about the stick. I know it wasn't like on the formal schedule that I put out on Sunday, but I've been meaning to do this. I should have been doing it a long time ago, but you're gonna love using the stick as part of our mobility stretching routine. But you also need the soft therapy balls. So these are just those squishy little balls that I've mentioned before that you can use to do soft tissue therapy. I got these at the Dollar Tree for $1 each in the toy bin. And they're a little bit squishy, but not where you can completely collapse it, you know, like the foam ones. And they kind of have a rubberized, rubbery texture, so when it's against your skin, it's not going to go scooting across the room the way maybe a tennis ball would because of that soft felt covering on a tennis ball. Plus, tennis balls really collapse. If you were to sit on one, you would probably squish it. This, not so much. It's going to push up into that soft tissue and achieve the purpose for which we're using it, and that is to do some soft tissue therapy, a little myofascial release, kind of unglue those sticky muscles. But let me just show you what I'm going to use here. I do have several sticks around, but I thought, well, I'll just show you. This is a Swiffer mop, right? You put the little Swiffer thingy on the end, and if you've got one, they unscrew very easily. So you just toss that, and now you have a yoga stick. But you want a stick that's pretty wide. Actually, one a little bit wider than this would be nice, but for now, this will do. And we're gonna use this in the warm-up. So I'm gonna do a little bit of a warm-up using this, and then we'll do our push-ups, our 20 reps rest, 15 reps rest, and then we'll go right into our stretching routine using this for a good bit of it, and then we'll do some yoga, and then we'll finish up using the balls to do the soft tissue therapy. So, who is here in the house? Is anybody awake? I see one person. I bet it's Izzy. Hi, Izzy. Hi. Jonathan is in the house. Hi, Jonathan. I know you sent me a message and I haven't responded back. I'm sorry. You should never read a text or look at it when you're driving, because then, you know, it shows that it's been read and then you forget to go back and reply. But anyhow, I did get your message and I'm just glad that you're here. It's a beautiful day out. All right, so we'll start with the stick. Another thing you could use, somebody gave me this years ago. It's like, I call it the Moses cane. It's a beautiful hand-carved wooden stick. It's actually longer than this one, so I might use this at some point. But it's real soft, so if you've got a beautiful cane like this, it's real tall, that would be good too. Or even a PVC pipe. You can go to Home Depot and get a PVC pipe that's probably twice this length for less than $2. So it's cheap. It's not like it's an expensive fitness tool. You know, I'm big on saving y'all money. I mean, I'm not going to be promoting some stick that costs $39.99. Yeah, that's just ridiculous, right? Okay, so let's begin. You're going to stand with your feet maybe just a smidge wider than hip distance apart. And then I want you to hold the stick at the very outer edges there. We're going to take a big inhale breath. Arms come up. Exhale, let the arms drop back just until it, you know, feels like a stretch, not discomfort. Inhale up, and then exhale down to the quads there. And when you get here, just push a little bit into those thighs, kind of activating those muscles on the back side. Inhale breath, reach up. Exhale breath, press down. Again, inhale, reaching up. Exhale down. Inhale, reach up. Exhale down. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, down. Let's do two more. Inhale, reach up and back. Exhale, down. One more time. Inhale, breath up. And then exhale, down. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bend the elbows so that the stick is right there kind of on your traps. And then we're just going to turn ever so slightly from left to right. Keep your legs straight. Try to keep your hips fairly fixed. I mean, they're going to turn a little bit, but just a comfortable rotation. You're not trying to wrench it and yank it around, right? So it should just feel good, just warming up that torso. loosening up that spine and just breathing easy. Watch your breath. Inhale, exhale. Again, inhale, exhale. One more time each way. Inhale and then exhale. Good. Now stretch those arms straight up here. Again, holding out pretty wide. You're going to inhale, drop those arms over to your right. Exhale, stand up nice and tall. And then inhale, drop those arms over to the left. So it's almost as if you're pulling down with that downward hand, keeping this top arm up straight. And then exhale to the top. Here we go. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, dip to the left. Exhale it up. Inhale. Exhale. So you're keeping the legs straight, maybe shifting the hips a little bit away from where the arms are going, and then up to the top. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more time each side. Inhale down. And then exhale up. Inhale down. Exhale up. Okay, one more. So this one, we're going to bring it right to the small of your back. Okay, so right there. And then just hook your arms over. And maybe you could even grab the ends if you want. And we're just going to stand and do some more rotation. But this time, kind of dip into the hips. Kind of bend both knees and twist. And then twist. So if you push, say right here, I'll face you so you can get it right as far as the left right goes. Push with your right hand. It's going to automatically force this left arm back and open up that chest. And you're going to feel a stretch in your left hip as well. So let's do that slowly a few times to each side. So push with your left hand and it's automatically forcing that right one back. Look over your shoulder. Inhale. And then exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale. One more time, exhale. Good, now just drop the arms down, hold close together, and just push those arms away. Lift your chin up, inhale, breath. And then exhale it out. Very good. All right, so let's hit those push-ups, and then we're gonna come back up and continue with the stick warm-up, all right? So I'm just gonna do traditional style push-ups this morning. You are free to do them anyway. I've showed you lots of different ways to do them. You can do dumbbell presses if you prefer, or push-ups against the windowsill, the desk, the countertop, the couch, whatever you want. All right, so hands come out here in front, and we're gonna go inhale down, exhale, press up. Inhale, exhale. Halfway there, 10 more reps up. Inhale, exhale, 9, 8, 7, 6, 3 more, 2 more, 1 more time. Inhale, down, exhale, up, and then just push those hips back, walk the hands together, child's pose stretch. Good, and then just come up into the high kneeling position. Bring those arms behind. Quick little stretch here. As you open up through the chest, pull the shoulders back and down, lift the chin, and then push those arms away if you can. Big inhale breath here. And then exhale, pull the navel in, round the back, spread your shoulder blades there. Inhale, push those hands out and up. And then exhale, rotate your wrists around and around. All right, set number 2, here we go, 15 reps. If you wanna try and do negatives for a few, the way you would do it is you would straighten the legs out, you would come down super, 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 super slow, then drop the knees and push up. Let's just do maybe 5 that way and then we'll finish it up regular style. So that was 1, here's 2, down slow, drop your knees, push. Here's 3, slow, 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 slow down, drop your knees and push. Come on, 2 more, inhale, drop the knees, exhale, push. Last time, straight legs, inhale on the down. Drop your knees, exhale, up, 10 more, down, up, 10, 9, 8, 7, exhale, 6, come on, 5, inhale, exhale, 4, 3, 2, one more time, all the way down if you can't push, all the way up, and then sit back, child's pose, inhale, breath, exhale. All righty, so I'm gonna just stretch my mat out. Bring it back here a little bit. All right, so come up to a high kneeling position. Stretch your arms up overhead, inhale. Exhale, chest expansion. Bring the hands behind the back. Tuck the glutes under, push the hips forwards, roll the shoulders back and down, lift the chin, look up, inhale. And then exhale, breath. Clasp here in front. Pull the navel in, round the back as you drop your hips back, chin to the chest. And then push those hands out and up. Inhale, breath. And then exhale. Circle your wrists all the way down and then shake it out. Okay, grab your stick. You can even use your stick to kind of help you up. How about that? Tuck your toes under. Stand on up. And then let's, if you're just joining in, and it is time to start, we are using a stick for the first part here. This is actually a Swiffer mop thing, and I just unscrewed it. It's real easy to unscrew. So go get that real quick, or if you've got a PVC pipe or a walking cane or just a wooden dowel or just anything, even a broom. If there's a broom on the end, no big deal. It'll still work. So we're gonna stand, feet maybe a little bit wider apart, toes are facing straight ahead, and grab at the very outer edges of the stick. So a bigger stick, a longer stick would be ideal, and maybe at some point, you know, all of us can accumulate that, and then we can really do some pretty cool things. But for now, this will work. So here we go, it's inhale, breath up. Exhale, turn to the right. Inhale, center. Exhale, turn left. Inhale. Exhale, twist to the right. So really try to rotate around. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist left. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Now let's just continue to twist, and you're gonna bend the knees a little bit as you do it. And then you're gonna drop that left arm down here, keeping right hand high. So inhale, exhale, drop the right arm across, keep the left arm high. So inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale up, exhale, twist, inhale up, exhale, twist. So the nice thing about the stick is you've kind of got this fixed thing to hold on to, so it sort of ensures that you're gonna get a good stretch if you're doing it right. If you were just doing this without the stick, you might not get quite the stretch that we can feel with the stick, because you can sort of lock this arm out and hold it there and kind of force it into a stretch. Let's do one more on each side. Inhale, exhale, inhale, and then exhale. Good, now bring it in a little bit closer. We're gonna go under and over. Under and over. So start to lunge with it. So when you lunge to the right, drop the right hand down. When you lunge left, drop the left hand down. So we go right, we go left. So when you're doing that, you should feel a wonderful stretch all the way down the lats into that hip. And we go right, and we go left. Let's go four more. Four, three, two, one. Now bring it here in front, and then you're gonna lunge over to the right. You're gonna drop this left hand down here, and as you kind of push up with the left hand, it's gonna automatically force that right arm up. Now I'm gonna kind of rest my hand, wrist, maybe even forearm on that quad, and then turn my head to look up. My left leg is straight, so I'm feeling a wonderful inner thigh stretch. Come up, inhale, breath. exhale, push down with the right hand. It automatically drives that left hand up. Park the hand on that quad. Right leg is straight, left knee bent. Look up at your hand. Inhale. Exhale, sweep to the right. Inhale up. Exhale, sweep it to the left. Inhale. So as you kind of park that hand, wrist on that quad, this arm has no choice to get a stretch, right? Inhale up, and then exhale, take it to the left. Inhale up, exhale, take it to the right. Inhale, exhale left. Who knew that a mop would one day become a fitness tool? Isn't that just amazing? I love it. I love using everyday ordinary stuff around the house for a totally different purpose. We are repurposing the Swiffer mop. Lunge to the right, inhale, exhale, lunge left. Inhale, exhale, lunge right. Good, now stop here in the center. I want you to walk your feet a little bit closer together. And again, toes are forwards. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna squat. You're gonna right away push this right hand under. I want you to dig your right elbow into that right inner thigh. And then this hand is gonna push up and you're gonna look up. So a little bit more extreme stretch. Both knees are bent here. Good, inhale up. Go the same direction. So we're gonna do six on this side, six on the other. So there's two, park that elbow on the inside of the right knee. Inhale up, exhale, squat and push that left arm up. Inhale up, exhale. Inhale, breath up, exhale. Inhale, exhale. And then inhale, go the other side. So squat, push this left arm under. You're gonna dig that left elbow right there on the inside of your left thigh, and then you're gonna push up and stretch those right chest and shoulder muscles. Here we go, inhale. And then exhale, park that elbow there, push that hand up. Inhale, exhale. So put, it's like you're doing a little bicep curl there with that left arm. Three more, inhale, and exhale, breath. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, breath. Good, and then come on up. Good, now just park it across your quads, and then we're just gonna twist this way. So you're sort of rolling the stick over your outer hip around to the back of the glutes there, and as you're pushing, it's stretching, as you can see, my right lats, shoulders, obliques, QL. Inhale, center. Exhale, I push this way and it forces that arm there, just so you can kind of see what's going on. So the knees bend and then you do a little twist and look around to the back. And then inhale, center. Exhale, bend both knees, twist, look around to the left. Feels really good on that lower back. Exhale, twist to the right. Inhale, breath. Exhale, twist left. Inhale, exhale. We don't want to go too fast on this because there's an element of balancing, so we don't want to lose our balance. Inhale, one more each way. Exhale, twisting right. Inhale, breath. Exhale, twist to the left. Inhale, center. Good, so grab the very outer edges. You probably still have it there, but just in case you got in closer, grab the outer edges. So I want you to reach those arms out, up, and then just go back however far back you can go. Now, believe it or not, the name of this is shoulder dislocation. Sounds horrible, I know, but there is a point where you really can go back and all the way down. Now, if that hurts, don't try to force it. You know, if you're having to go, just don't go there. Just go back as far as you can, keeping both arms straight. But that would be a good goal to reach for, getting the ability in the shoulders to come all the way to there, and then come all the way up, and then down to the front. And then inhale, breath up. Exhale down. This is why you might want a really long stick, because the wider the hands, the easier it is to go. Again, inhale up, exhale down. Inhale, reach those arms up. Exhale, over you go. So this is really breaking up any scar tissue, any adhesions that might be kind of locking your shoulder in a fixed position. You know, if you have a shoulder injury, physical therapists, what they do, and they have just this uncanny ability to push you through your own pain, and they kind of seem to don't care because they know that they're doing your body good. And I've seen it in action where a physical therapist was rehabbing a girl's shoulder. She'd had rotator cuff surgery, and my office was right on the other side of the room where they were doing PT. And I could hear this girl was like banging on the wall, and I'm like, what is going on? I went out there, and she was banging on the wall because it hurt. I said, do you need to be rescued? She goes, yes. But you know, I mean, we were just kind of laughing, but you know, this girl, the physical therapist, is just yanking her arm up and around, and just, it's like the fact that she was almost in tears didn't even faze her. So all that to say that sometimes you have to move a little bit through those points of pain in the body to get better, to release something, to increase your flexibility and your mobility. All right, enough of those. Roll your shoulders around to the back. All right, this mat just does not want to stay still. Mat on carpet does not work. Okay, so super wide stance again, right? So holding the very outer points of your stick, inhale. And then exhale, you're gonna bend the right knee. This time you're gonna drop the right hand down and then just kind of park your elbow there and push up and back. So we're gonna do six on this same side. Inhale, that's one. Exhale, here's two. Inhale up, exhale three. Inhale up, and then exhale four. Inhale up, exhale five. Inhale up, one more time. Exhale six, hold it here, hold it here. Good, now come up, inhale. Exhale, bend your left knee, bend your left arm. Keep that right arm straight as it's kind of holding over the top of the stick. Park your elbow there and push up to get that wonderful stretch. Yeah, inhale, exhale. Inhale, if you have a bamboo stick, that'll work too. Inhale, exhale. Inhale up, exhale breath. Big deep side lunge there. Come on, one more time. Inhale, and then exhale breath. Inhale breath up. Exhale, roll your shoulders around. So next we're gonna go into a kneeling position. So hopefully you've got a mat that's pretty cushy. If not, fold it up so that there's a lot more cush and protection for your knee. So what I want you to do is step your right foot forwards. You're just gonna come into a kneeling position here. It's not meant to be like this real far out here kind of lunge stretch. You're just two right angles basically with your legs. And then just make sure that there's not like glass window right there. You don't want to like bam, you know, break anything, because we're going to be doing, you know, big range of motion here. So square the hips, ribs, chest, shoulders, all straight ahead. And then I want you to just press down by this left hip. So you're going to sweep it back there and then come up and then rotate around to the right. Look over that right shoulder and then come back down here. And then up and twist. And then come down. And then up and twist. Three more on this side. Inhale. Exhale, up and twist. Inhale, breath. A little balancing here, right? Inhale. Exhale. Let's do one more. Inhale, sweep it this way. And then exhale up. Hold it here. Twist, twist, twist. And then come back, and we're just gonna switch legs, all right? I have to kind of laugh, because the guy that was, have watched several videos on this before, and one of the guys doing a video, he commented, he said, I know I lost count, I can't count, you know, trainers can't count, I'm a trainer. And I was like, yes, somebody else. So I'm totally aware that I lose count on a lot of stuff. You know, we would rather teach than just count reps. Need a little rep counter over here. It would be a great job for an elementary school kid. All right, so left foot is front. You're gonna push and kind of sweep the stick past this right hip back there. And then we come up to the top and then we're gonna twist. Try to look over that left shoulder that way. So here we go, inhale. Exhale, inhale, exhale up, whew. Inhale, exhale, twist even more around to the left side, in again, inhale, breath, exhale up and twist, inhale, exhale, let's do two more, inhale, and then exhale, inhale, exhale. Good, now this next one, I kind of want to turn my mat this way. I just kind of went that way so you could see, I'm hoping, better. So bring your right foot forwards, left knee, kneeling on the left, okay? And then just hold the stick over your head here. You're gonna go over to the right, inhale up. Exhale over to the left. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale up. Exhale, drop over to the left. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. So you're pulling down, trying to keep this left arm locked out. Inhale up. Exhale, same deal here. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, one more, inhale, exhale, good. Now we're just gonna switch legs, so you can set your stick down to kind of help with that if you want, and then set your left foot forwards, and you're just in that 90-90. It's not meant to be like this big time stretching lunge. You're just in this nice kneeling position, kind of tucking the tail under, firming the core, arms are straight up over your head. Ready, here we go. So we're gonna just dip it over to the left here, stretching that right side of the body. Inhale, exhale, take it right. Inhale, breath up. Exhale, go left. Inhale, breath up. Try to get those arms locked out straight. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, breath. Inhale, breath. Exhale, over to the right. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And then one more on each side. Inhale up. Exhale, over you go. Inhale. And then exhale, over to the right. And then inhale, breath up. Yeah, exhale, and then just set your stick down. And then you're gonna come into a tabletop position. I'm just gonna kind of spin my mat back a little bit this way so I can come into tabletop. So for now, just have your stick there at the top of your mat. We are gonna do a few more things with it, but for right now, right here, a little cat-cow action. Ready? Inhale, breath, straight arms, spread the fingers, belly drops, head up. Exhale, breath, round your spine, draw the navel in. So you should at this point already feel nice and warm, body loose. Inhale, breath, let the belly drop, head up. And then exhale, breath, rounding your spine, contracting your abdominal muscles really strong as you draw them in towards the back of your spine. Two more times, inhale, head up, belly drops. Exhale, breath round. Inhale, breath, head up. And then exhale, breath, round. Good, now walk the hands towards the very top of the mat, downward puppy, inhale. And then on the exhale, just drop the head, the chest down, but try to keep your hips high, stacked over those knees. Good, now round the back, come on up, and then walk forwards. I want you to take your stick and just set it on the end of your mat. What you don't want is a stick, I was watching one class, and I kind of didn't get it. They had wooden sticks, but they were on wooden floors, so everybody was sliding all over the place and sticks were falling. And I was like, put it on the mat. Okay, so hands are gonna be stacked right on top of your stick. Now, if your stick's like super high, and you wanna be a little bit above shoulder level, you could just drop your hands down and hold there, but I'm gonna just stack mine on top. So as I'm straight up here, arms are extended, that stick should be straight up and down. So inhale breath, on an exhale breath, I'm gonna push the hips back slightly, push the stick forwards, and then drop my head down. So it's like this wonderful chest lat stretch. Now round the back, tuck the tail, roll it up, inhale breath, look forwards. And then exhale breath, push the hips back, drop your head through, maybe arch that back a bit, and then just take it into that deep, deep stretch for the chest, the shoulders, the lats. Even abdominals getting a good stretch. Tuck the tail, roll it up, inhale. Exhale breath, push the hips back, drop your head down. Two more, inhale, roll it up. Exhale. One more time, tuck the tail, round the back up, inhale. And then exhale breath, down you go. Good, and then roll it up. Ha! How's that feel? All right, set the stick back down. And then you're in tabletop position. What I want you to do is stretch your right leg back, left arm up. Now, float the right leg up to where it feels like it's parallel. Hold it there, inhale. Exhale, sweep this arm around. See if you can bend the knee and touch your foot, your toes, grab your pants maybe, grab an ankle, whatever you can, and then just straighten that right arm out. Try to push that foot up and breathe. Release, inhale, stretch arm and leg back out. Exhale, elbow and knee bend, round the back, squeeze your abdominals here. Reach back out again, inhale, breath. Exhale, bend the knee, sweep this left arm around, and then grab a hold, and then lift head and chest up for a stretch. Inhale. Exhale. Release, inhale, stretch it out. Exhale, elbow and knee come together underneath. Inhale, stretch it out. Exhale, hand and knee down, and then round the back, tuck the chin, push your hips back towards those heels, and then walk your hands out. Wonderful child's pose stretch. Breathe. Long inhale here. Exhale it out. All right, come back up into tabletop position. Extend right arm out, left leg back, and then float your leg up. Inhale. Exhale, bend the knee, sweep this arm back. Find a toe, foot, ankle, pants, whatever you can. If nothing, you're just here. That's totally fine too, to just be right there. So don't feel like, you know, you're a failure just because you can't grab your foot. Release, inhale, stretch arm and leg out, inhale. Exhale, elbow and knee bend, the back rounds, the belly pulls up and in, you squeeze elbow and knee into each other, contracting your abdominals there. Reach back out, inhale, lengthen. Exhale, bend the knee, sweep this right arm around, grab a hold of whatever you can, and then lift and bring your head up and stretch that whole underside. Inhale. Exhale. Release, inhale, stretch it out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, reach it out. Exhale, hand and knee down, round the back. Push those hips back, walk the hands out. And again, child's pose stretch. Breathe. Good, come back up. So from here, I want you to tuck your toes under and back, and then you're just gonna kinda drag your toes across the mat. And as you're doing that, you're gonna feel a stretch right where those toes attach into the body of your foot. Should feel good, should feel good stretch on the underside, that's your plantar fascia. Good. Now, keep your toes tucked under. Gaze forwards, inhale, breath. On an exhale breath, lift the knees up and then push your sit bones back. So now you feel your belly kind of pushing on top of those upper thighs. And just stay there for a breath. Inhale. Exhale it out. One more time, inhale breath. Now on the exhale breath, you're gonna straighten your legs all the way up and then melt your heels to the back of the mat. Maybe shimmy, shimmy your feet further back. Oh yeah, good stretch for those calf muscles. Now just kind of walk it out here, pedaling it out, back and forth from one foot to the other. Good, now both legs super straight, feet are together. Arms are nice and straight, fingers spread wide. Inhale, breath. Exhale. So from here, lift your head up a little bit. I want you to drop down onto your forearms and we're taking it into dolphin stretch. So it looks like down dog, you're just simply resting on the forearms. To me, it is easier. Some people have said they think it's harder. Feel free to do just regular down dog if you wish, but I think the forearm version, the dolphin pose, to me, feels easier. All right, so we're gonna do some alternating leg lifts, starting with the right. Reach your toes to the back and then up, up, up you go. Inhale, breath. Exhale, bend the knee, and then try to just lift that knee up a little bit. Take a little peek under your right arm. Good, straighten your leg back out, inhale. Exhale, lower your foot down next to the left and switch. Inhale, breath, left leg goes to the back wall and up, up higher if you can. And then exhale, bend the knee, and as you do that, try to open up the hips to the left. Take a little peek underneath your left arm here. Breathe. Straighten it up, square it up. Inhale, straighten your left leg up. And then exhale, down. One more time for the right leg. Let's go. Inhale, reach the toes up and back. Exhale, bend the knee, and then open up. Now, can you straighten out your right arm? Keep that left elbow down. This allows you to get a little more rotation there in the hips. Good, now drop that elbow back down to the mat. Square up your hips and shoulders. Kick your right leg up straight, inhale. And then exhale, breath, lower your foot down, switch sides. Inhale, breath, left leg goes up. Exhale, bend the knee, open up the hips. Now if you want, place that left hand down and just straighten that arm out. And then turn a little bit more. Breathe. Good, drop that elbow down, square up the hips, kick your leg up straight, inhale. Exhale, breath, set your foot down. Good, now from there, drop down to the knees, uncurl your toes, push those hips back and stretch it out. Good, now slide your hands all the way back to the knees, onto those upper thighs, and then roll your shoulders around to the back. Inhale, breath, stretch the arms out and up. Exhale, breath, draw your hands right through to heart center. So when you're doing this, this is kind of like your centering breath, centering pose, bringing the shoulders back and down, bringing that chin back. Do it again, inhale up. Long exhale, breath out here. Good, now slide those hands all the way out to the top of the mat. Tuck the toes under, inhale. Exhale, breath, straighten the legs. Let's go ahead and push on back into downward facing dog now. So you should look like the letter A from the side, and you want the weight pretty evenly distributed on the hands and the feet. So not too much weight into the legs and then not too much into the upper body as well. Let's float that right leg up for a three-leg dog, inhale. Exhale, flex the foot, bend the knee, open up your chest and your hips to the right. Take a little peek under your right arm. Circle your right ankle around. Good, now square it back up, kick the leg up straight, inhale. And then exhale, swing your foot through, step right between the hands for a lunge and then drop, back knee down. Inhale, stretch those arms out and up here. Exhale, breath, float the hands back down to the mat. Tuck the toes under, straighten the back leg out. Inhale here. And then exhale, breath. Stretch that right leg back up once again into a three-leg dog. Inhale. Exhale, lower that leg down next to the left. And let's do that same sequence on the other leg. Ready, go. Inhale, left leg up, three-leg dog. Exhale, flex the foot, bend the knee, rotate your hips. Look underneath your arm and circle your ankle around. Couple times each way. Breathe. And then square it up. Kick your leg up straight. Point your toes. Inhale. And then exhale, breath. Swing your foot through. Step right between the hands for a lunge. Drop that back knee down. Reach the arms out and up. Inhale here. And then exhale, breath. Float your hands down to the mat. Tuck your back toes under. Straighten your leg. Inhale. And then exhale. Go back up into a three-leg dog here. And then set your foot down. Good, drop the knees super, super wide, toes are touching. Walk the hands way out and thumbs are touching together there. This time, as you push back, drop the elbows, flip the palms up, head comes down, elbows bend to touch beyond the neck, and then push those hips back. Feel that wonderful stretch through your triceps. Good, extend the arms back out, flip the hands over, inhale, breath, lift up. Exhale, toes tuck under, and then straighten your legs all the way up again, downward facing dog. Here we go with some three-leg dog action. Right leg goes up again, inhale, reach your toes up. On an exhale breath, you're gonna come into plank. You're gonna bend the knee so it's right underneath this right hip. Then you're gonna just stretch your leg over there to the left and then reach your left arm out. Inhale. Exhale, float that hand back down, bend that knee, go back up into a three-leg dog again. So inhale, breath. Exhale, breath, coming into plank, bend that knee under, drop your right hip and then shoot that leg over there and then reach this left arm out. Maybe turn your body more to face the side. Inhale, look up. And then exhale, hand to the mat. Drive that knee right up there in between the hands, drop onto your hip, and then uncurl those toes in back. Lower your chest down here over that thigh. So however far you can go, that's just where you go. Don't worry about being not low enough. You just go where it feels good for your body, and then it is enough. Good, now bring your hands right beside your knee here. Inhale, press up. And then exhale, come back down. Slide your hands out a little bit farther in front if you're able to do that. And then drop your head down. Slide your hands back a little bit. Inhale, breath up we go. This time you're gonna thread the needle. So take this left hand, palm is facing up, thread it underneath and see if you can rotate that torso and drop that left shoulder down. Oh yeah, wonderful stretch all across that low back. And then just give a little push down with that right hand or stretch your right arm up here. Breathe, inhale. Exhale. Drop that arm back a little more, inhale. Exhale. Good, slowly lower that right hand down right by your face and then just come out of it slowly. You never want to go in or out of a stretch fast. Take your time, give those muscles a chance to unwind or wind. So from here, you're going to tuck the back toes under, straighten your leg up, inhale, breath. And then on the exhale, one more three-leg dog here, just stretching that leg up. Good, and then just float your leg down, set it right next to the left, and we'll do all that on the other side. So here we go, left leg reaches up to the ceiling, inhale. And then on the exhale breath, you're gonna shift into plank, so shoulders right over those wrists, scoop your belly, drop that knee so it's hanging just right underneath that left hip, and then a little turn, stretch your leg there, reach the right arm over your head, just stretching it that way, inhale. And then exhale, breath. Bring your hand back down. Back up you go. Into three-leg dog. Inhale, breath. And then exhale, breath. Again, it's plank. The knee comes under. Squeeze those abs up and in. Extend the leg over there to the right. This time, reach the arm here. Or if you're able to, open up the body more. Look up at the ceiling there. Push your hips up high. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Stay there. Inhale, breath. And then exhale, breath. Turn to face the mat. Place that right hand down. And then just drive that left knee up here in between your hands. Relax that back leg down. And then just lower your chest over. Ah, should feel good. However far you go, that's just where you go. Breathe. Good, now slide the hands back beside your knee again. Inhale, lift up. And then exhale, walk your hands out. Slide them out there if you can for this stretch a little deeper. Drop your head down. Good, and then lift your head up. Slide the hands in a bit. Inhale, lift your head and chest up. Here we go with thread the needle. So pick up your right hand, palm is facing up. You're gonna slide this arm across. Now you might notice one side's looser than the other. For me, this is definitely my tighter side. For most people, I would assume that twisting to the left is gonna be your tighter side. My theory is that all the years that you've been driving since you were 16 years old or whenever you got your license, you were constantly twisting your torso right to back up in the parking lot or out of the driveway because you were looking over your shoulder and we didn't have backup cameras till just a while ago. So let's drop that shoulder down however far you can, and then you can push with this hand or stretch this left arm up and look up. Inhale, breath. Exhale it out. Again, inhale, maybe drop that arm back some more. Exhale it out. Gonna float this hand gently down, place the hand there, push yourself back up, hands right there beside that knee, tuck your toes under, lift the knee, inhale. And then on the exhale breath, take it back up into a wonderful three-leg dog stretch. Open up that split inhale. And then exhale breath, float your leg down. Good enough from here. Knees out wide, toes touching. Push the hips back into an extended child's pose stretch. Good, now come on up. So I want you to walk on your knees up towards the top of your mat. Cross your ankles and then just push yourself back to a sit position. And then I want you to grab your stick. Again, we're gonna use the stick to assist with some hamstring stretches here. I have to tell you about a trick I saw with a stick. There, I mean, there's no way I would even, I don't think, do it in this class unless you want me to, but how was it? The stick was underneath the ankles and then the head was in front of the stick and then somehow they came up like this, you know, and the legs are back there and the stick is here. I don't know if you can even imagine that, but I was just like looking and then, it's that same class where the stick was scooting across the wood floor and the girl was just like stuck there and everybody was taking pictures and she fell over. Everybody ran over to pick her up. I'm like, yeah, I'm not gonna be doing that pose. So just in case you were worried. All right, sit at the very front of your mat. Grab your stick. Inhale, breath. Exhale, breath. Slowly, slowly, slowly lower your spine down to the floor and I want you to bring your right knee in. Can you step your foot right there on that stick and go ahead and rest your head down. So inhale, breath. You're gonna pull with your arms this way. So it's kind of jamming that thigh and that knee towards you. So inhale, breath here. Exhale, see how far up you can straighten the leg. So you might only get it a little bit, that's fine. Or maybe you can straighten the leg a lot. I got a wall in the way, so I gotta kind of move my stick some there. Good, now bend the knee, flex the foot, stretch the left leg out straight. Inhale, breath. Exhale, bend your elbows so you're trying to pull the stick towards you. You're pulling the thigh and the knee towards you. Inhale here. And then exhale, breath. Try to straighten that leg up as much as you can. Again, it could be right there. Wherever it goes is where it goes. You're still going to feel a stretch in the hamstrings even if your knee is bent. So don't feel like you're doing it wrong just because your knee is still bent. It's still stretching. You just get a little bit more if you do straighten it all the way. And then just hold it here for one nice long breath. Inhale. And then exhale it out. Good, now bend the knees and then just take that stick away. Bring your knees together and then we're just gonna kind of rock a little bit side to side there, giving that lower back a little bit of a massage. And then step your right foot down, step your foot on the stick. Inhale, on the exhale, try to jam that knee in towards the chest so you're pulling with your arms, getting a little upper body strength training in here. Good, inhale. And then exhale, see if you can kick the leg up straight. So wherever it goes, that's where it goes. You're just kind of letting that stick guide your leg up. Should feel a wonderful stretch in your hamstrings. Good, now bend the knee back down. Extend the right leg down all the way straight across the mat. Inhale here. Exhale, bend those elbows. So again, you're trying to pull that thigh in towards your chest. Stay there, inhale, breath. Exhale, breath. This time, kick the leg back up again straight. However far out you can go is fine. So again, even if the knee is slightly bent, you will feel a hamstring stretch. I'm pretty confident of that. And then just draw that leg in however far you can. Breathe, nice long inhale. And then exhale it out. Good job, and then bend that knee. Good, now this time I want you to bring the knees together, but bring that stick behind the knees there. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a little, it's called effleurage, or just like a little massage, kind of like foam rolling with a super, super skinny roller across the hamstrings. And then we're gonna do those same two stretches again and just see if you go maybe a little bit farther. So you're just kind of vigorously going from the backs of the knees down to maybe where the hamstrings almost get up towards those glutes. Good, and then if you want to hit the calves, do an underhand grip like that, and then just kind of roll. Oh, goodness. Yeah, if you've got tight calves, it's definitely going to feel a little tender there. Alrighty, so set your left foot down. Keep the right knee with you. Set your right foot on the stick. Draw that thigh into your chest, inhale. Exhale, give it a good squeeze, knee to the chest. Again, inhale. Exhale, breath, try to extend the leg up straight. However far you can go, that's where you go. Stay there, inhale, breath. Exhale it out. Good, now bend the knee, flex your foot, inhale. Stretch that left leg down long. Exhale, draw that right knee again into your chest. Inhale here. Exhale, breath, extend the leg up however far you can go and stretch the hamstrings again. And just note, did you go farther than the first time? I mean, probably you did because it is the second time around, but probably you did because of that nice little massage with the stick across those hamstrings. Stay there, inhale. Exhale. Good, now bend both knees. Take your foot off and then just sort of hold the stick right over the knees and just a little rocking motion side to side there. Should feel good. Kind of a little massage for your lumbar spine. And then set your right foot down. Step your left foot on the stick. Inhale, breath. Exhale, breath, bending your elbows. So you're pulling, it's like you're doing an upright row here with your arms, right? So not such a bad thing. And then jam that knee in towards your chest. Maybe it comes out here to the side a little bit towards your left shoulder. Good. Now release away. Inhale. On the exhale, do it again and extend the right leg down all the way straight. You're going to feel a wonderful stretch across the right hip flexors as you draw that left knee in. Now inhale, breath here. Exhale, breath. Extend the leg up however far you can go. And just draw that leg in for a stretch in your hamstrings. Stay there. Inhale. Exhale it out. Good, and then just bending the knees. Let go, and let's again place that stick right underneath your knees there. Bend the knees, and then underhand grip, roll back and forth across the calves. You can kind of, don't get right on those Achilles tendons. You never want to rub, especially this stick, because it's so hard. Stop right before you get to that point, but you could get right where maybe it starts to grow into a muscle. I mean, a tendon is nothing more than a muscle that sort of becomes a tendon to attach into the bone. It just becomes more fibrous and sort of tough as a muscle versus a muscle that's soft and pliable. All right, and then do the hamstrings as well here. All right, now back to overhand grip. Tuck the chin, extend those legs out, and then just rock and roll. So draw the legs in, push away, draw the legs in, and then come all the way up to sit, yeah. And then just set your stick away over there. All right, so face the front in a straddle sit position. Again, just my moving mat here. So straddle however far feels comfortable for you. Okay, so that could be right here. You might be able to get way out here, but then your knees start to bend and sort of roll in like that. That puts a lot of torque on the knee. So better that you be in a little bit closer and have good form than be out here and all, you know, kind of goofed up in your alignment. So wherever that is for you, hands are going to be right here on the mat in front. We're going to just side to side. So we drop the shoulder to the right knee, left shoulder to left knee here. So just nice and easy, just taking your time, not hanging out there for very long. Just kind of get over there and come back up. Inhale as you drop, exhale up, inhale, drop, exhale up. Now start to sweep the opposite arm across towards the foot there. Inhale, reach over, exhale up, inhale, reach over, exhale up again. Two more, inhale. Exhale, inhale, exhale. Now this time we're gonna come over here with both hands and stay a while. So try to drop the head and chest down over that leg. And if you feel like this knee is starting to roll in, just intentionally rotate that hip, rotate that thigh in the hip socket so the kneecap is facing up as you come over here. Good, and then just slowly take your time coming up. Inhale, and then exhale, take it over here to the right. Same deal, if this is starting to roll in, either bring it closer or just be very intentional about rotating your thigh outwards from the hip there so kneecap stays facing up as you reach over here to the right leg and just breathe. Inhale, exhale. Just coming back up, inhale, breath here, and then exhale, slide your hands forwards however far you can go, and just walk, walk, walk your fingertips out, stretching in that straddle stretch. Good, and then roll it back up, walk those hands in here. And then hands come behind you and then just shake your legs out back to center. All right, so your therapy balls, your tennis balls, your super balls, your bouncy balls, the play balls, whatever you've got, get those. And we are gonna do just three things here and we'll finish, the last one will be standing up. But the first one is gonna be for the upper traps, the neck area here, because that is where pretty much everybody carries a lot of tension, right? So we're gonna sit And then we're gonna roll down. And then we're gonna take those balls and we're gonna park them right on either side of the spine, but push them down. Not right on the neck, but below the neck, but one on either side of the spinal column. You don't wanna be right on the spine. And then just interlace the fingers behind your head. Walk your feet in and set the feet out. Go ahead and drop your head down and then let your elbows flare out. So for some of you, just this right here alone is enough to kind of be, I feel tension, I feel pressure, I feel a little tenderness. That's okay, you just stay right there. But if you want more, you're gonna draw the belly in, lift the hips up. And now, I'm just gonna kind of open up the elbows and then close them together and drop. Point them up, open out. So elbows close together and then they drop down. I'm kind of looking down my thighs to the knees and then we come back up and open out. Two more times, together with the elbows and then drop. So my hips are still lifted off the floor. Drop the head down, open the elbows up. One more, elbows together, tuck the chin and then drop and then open. Good. Now next, you're going to drop your hips back down to the floor, still feeling pressure. Maybe just push a little bit to kind of scoot the balls down a little further down the back. Now draw that navel in, and then I want your arms to just be extended straight up. Imagine that you're driving a big city bus. Everybody's been on a city bus, and those steering wheels, I don't know why, they're like ginormous. It's like a hula hoop. Like, what's up with that? Anyways, pretend like you are driving and you're just gonna kind of ambulate the arms around in space like this, like you're circling, you're turning left, you're turning right. And as you're doing that, you should feel those balls kind of smushing around in those tissues, in the rhomboids, in the traps. And then just whatever you wanna do, you can just kind of be an octopus, arms here. And just as you're doing it, you'll notice, oh, this particular movement here feels good. It's really getting that knot back there. And you're gonna find knots, trust me. It feels like little wads of bubble gum lodged underneath your skin. And there's a knot right there. It kind of feels like you're going over a speed bump. You can almost feel it, you can see it. Massage therapists find it when they've got those magic thumbs on you. They just somehow they know exactly where those knots are and they go right to them and just dig in and put the hurt on you. All right, so this should be feeling good. And you know, you could just really, the whole body can be done that way. But just wanted to show you that for the back, and I just feel like the back is such a target zone for tension and stress. So next, we're gonna do three, so that's one. Number two is gonna be for the hands. Okay, so you wanna come up on your hands and your knees here, and just, you're literally gonna palm the ball like that. And then you're just gonna circle around. By the way, this is a great shoulder rehab exercise that's often done. Usually it's up against a wall standing, but you can do it here as well. And so you're just kind of massaging the palm of your hand. So if you have any arthritis, this might feel good, could be a little tender, especially on the, for whatever reason, it seems to want to start and get in those thumbs first. And then just kind of roll it back and forth, front to back, little circles, and then you can just kind of smush into it. And then smush into it. Good, all right, and then just set your balls down right there. And lastly, we're gonna do the bottoms of our feet. So come up to stand, make your way up, however you wanna make your way up. And then you're gonna stand up. So let's just start with your left foot, okay? So set the ball right underneath your big toe. So if this is a foot and this is your big toe, you're trying to push it back that way and really stretch right where the toe connects into the foot body. So you do that by bending the knee and kind of shifting the weight forwards. So you're kind of, you're just putting the hurt on this ball, right? I mean, they do get a little bit smushed and kind of out of shape, but within a minute they spring back. That's what I like about these balls. There's no need to spend $38 on a two sets of balls on the internet. When these run out of their firmness, you can just go buy another set for $2. Okay, now move to the middle toes. So now I'm almost kind of lifting my heel up, so it's also stretching the arch of my foot. Now I'm going down to the pinky toes, the baby toes, and then back to the middle toes. and then back to that big toe right here. All right, so now you're gonna set it underneath the ball of your foot and then just smush down on it a couple times there. And then just sort of move your foot slightly over to the right. Now smush down on it there. It's pushing right up into the center of the foot there. And then move it to the lateral edge of your foot there, right kind of below the pinky. Good, and then go back and back, and then go right to the middle of your foot. This is called pin and spin. So it's like you're doing the twist and you're just letting that ball just sort of grind up in there in that plantar fascia. That should feel really good. And then lastly, you bring it to the heel and then just kind of step on it, kind of smush the heel down into the ball. It's kind of a little bit of a balance thing here too. And then you're gonna do just a run, 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 run your foot across, yeah, the ball there. All right, do your left, right foot and we're done, okay? Don't leave now. You're gonna walk around lopsided all day long. So do your other foot, give your other foot equal pampering. So start with your right ball, toe, big toe, push, push, push. And then the center toes, push, push. So I'm sort of lifting my heel up like that and then down. I don't know if you can see that. This is my better ankle. And then there, center, and then middle toes. Ooh, right on that baby toe. Your poor feet don't ever get stretched. They don't get attention like this. So this is good for you. They hold you up. They are the base. They are the foundation. So if your feet aren't happy, it starts to send little compensatory movements throughout the body, and you carry that around with you all day long. And then all of a sudden it's nighttime and your back hurts or your headache is killing you. And it all could be rooted in the foot. Okay, go right to the ball of the foot and smush down on it there. And then move, so it's now in the center of your foot. And then move it all the way to the outer edge, the lateral kind of border of that foot, just below the pinky toe. And then move back through the middle, and then ball. Good, then set it right underneath the center of your foot, pin and spin. So you're just kind of rotating, that ball is just spinning around, it's grabbing that fascia and just in a circular pattern, stretching all that tissue there. It should feel really good. This is the best foot massage ever. Cheapest one ever. And right wherever it feels good, just dig right in there. If you have fallen arches, they probably are sore. They're probably tight. Your body needs this. And then just go to your heel. And again, just kind of push down. Let your heel smush on the ball like that. If you have plantar fasciitis, sometimes it feels like little gravel stones stuck inside your heel, and when you step it's very painful. And so you'll know that when you do this. It might be too much, but you probably need to be doing this if you have that plantar fasciitis. All right, and then lastly, just run, 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 run your foot over the ball like that. Give it a good little massage. And there you go. All right, so you are done. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, float your arms down, and you are all done. Hope you feel nice and stretched out. Hope you enjoyed the stick stretches. I think that they're excellent. It just allows you to get even deeper into many of those stretches that we sometimes do in yoga, and it kind of facilitates a deeper stretch. So y'all have a great weekend. Enjoy the beautiful weather, and I will see you guys on Monday. And eat healthy, drink lots of water, all that good stuff. Bye.